Steve, you're one of the co-chairs for Velocity this year. What's Velocity about?
Velocity is our fourth year, and it's really two camps that have come together, web performance and operations. And so I co-chair the web performance part. That's really about making things faster, mostly in terms of the user experience. So how long is the user left waiting for what they asked for? And then the operations side is chaired by Jesse Robbins, and that's about performance and speed, but more from a scalability efficiency perspective. If I have 500,000 or 500 million requests or users, how am I going to build a database for that that doesn't fall over? How am I going to serve up a website that can take that kind of load without getting buried? And so there are two, you know, like a lot of the stuff I'm talking about, we have, you know, Nicole Sullivan talking about CSS and Yehuda Katz talking about JavaScript. And then we have folks from Rackspace and Cisco talking about hardware, and then also kind of everything in between, in that app layer in between, talking about MySQL and faster databases and Hadoop and, you know, HTTP headers and networking protocols. And so, you know, it's a wide range, and these two groups are kind of from different backgrounds, but it's a really good combination because everyone is like an optimization geek. Like, how do we get the most efficiency we can out of what we're building? And there's something about these attendees where wanting to optimize stuff is just part of their nature. And so even though some of the techniques and technologies are different, everyone has the same kind of mindset.
And you've got a really great program this year, but what are the new elements in it?
Well, the main new thing, well, I guess there's two new things this year. The one that I'm really excited about is we added a mobile track. And I guess technically it's like a half track. We have a third ballroom, and on Thursday afternoon, that's going to be about velocity culture. But on Wednesday afternoon, so half of that track is on mobile performance. And so that's something that I've been focusing on for the last 6 months or so, 6 or 8 months. And, you know, I think to me it's very exciting because most of the time, 6 years ago when I started working on desktop web performance, everything was pretty bad. So if you talk to someone about, you know, don't you think the web is slow? Everyone was like, oh yes, oh my gosh, it's way too slow. Well, now, you know, especially in the top 100 sites in the world, a lot of people are paying attention to performance in what they deliver to the desktop, but we're still not getting that same level of optimization of performance best practices on mobile. So we're back. Yeah. So for me, I'm back. I'm like starting where I did 6 years ago on desktop. I'm doing that on mobile.
I mean, the World Wide Web is now a mobile phenomenon.
Yeah. Everyone I talk to, there's almost no, I don't know, maybe a dozen, in all the talks, the last dozen talks I've done at conferences, I always ask who here is happy with the speed of their mobile experience. And only once has one guy raised his hand and said, I'm happy. I said, oh, thanks for ruining the talk. But in general, 99.99% of the people out there, it's just too slow. And anything you can do to help these content providers, these companies, make what they're delivering faster, please do it.
So what's the difference? Is it the wireless pipe to the mobile device versus the wired pipe to your desktop, or is the problem elsewhere?
Well, I think certainly the network connection is a much bigger problem than it was on desktop. On desktop, without changing, you know, it took, back when I started, people were still doing dial-up. Well, you know, back then, 6 years ago, and even today, you can take a typical website and in 3 months make it twice as fast. And in 3 months, we're not seeing a significant shift in users' desktop bandwidth speeds, connection speeds. So, you know, we're able to work around that. It's going to be a lot harder on mobile to work around how slow the network is. But it's still, so the network performance, the carrier network you're using is still going to be a significant issue, bigger than it was on desktop. But there are still things we can do. Like if you use app cache, you know, manifest files, then you don't have to use the network To request 50 resources, you only need, the second time the user goes to the site, you only need, you know, a handful of requests. So again, even though the connection is going to be slower, there are techniques we can use to work around that.
Okay, so you basically you're caching everything you're caching everything on the device. Yeah.
And then certainly, you know, a big thing I've been evangelizing the last couple of years has been JavaScript and CSS performance, certainly especially JavaScript performance, and that applies, those techniques are even more important on the mobile device where you have less memory, weaker CPU typically. So the more we can get, and it's still the same thing is, you know, pretty much now across the, you know, top websites in the world, you're going to see compression and caching headers. And I'm looking at mobile versions of these top websites, and the stuff that they learned for desktop, it seems like they've unlearned it for mobile.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah, so I'm seeing mobile websites from these, you know, top destinations, and they're not caching anything. It's like, it's even more important here. Let's please turn that on.
Okay. Well, I have just one more question. I've heard a little bit about expanding velocity overseas. Can you say anything about that?
Yeah, well, last year we did, so, you know, this year's Velocity program in the U.S. is 50% bigger. We're up to about 1,800 people this year, I think. I don't have the final numbers yet because it actually hasn't started. But it's going to be big. It's going to be significantly bigger than last year. And, you know, that's exciting, but we also, you know, can't expect everyone in the world to come to this one event. That's going to be unmanageable. And so last year, we did the first O'Reilly conference in China. We did Velocity China in Beijing in December. That sold out. We're going to do that again this December. And then we're also looking at doing a Velocity in Europe. And we don't have any definite news yet, but I know Gina Blaber, the head of conferences here at O'Reilly, has been talking to some venues over there. And so I hope pretty soon we'll have an announcement about that.
Okay, that sounds really exciting.
Yeah, I think the people, I just got back from a couple mobile conferences in Europe, and people were asking, you know, could you bring Velocity to the EU? And so hopefully we'll have some good news on that pretty soon.
Okay, well, that's great. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thanks.